Welcome. Today we're going to talk about the discriminant. First of all, I want to talk just generally about quadratics. Here's a typical quadratic. Let's plot it. It's pretty standard in the parabolic shape. It's got two roots. A root is a place where y is equal to 0, and it's got a root around minus 4.5 and about plus 1/2. If I vary the y-intercept here, which is the minus 2 part of the equation, I'm going to not change the gradient. For any given x value, the gradient will be the same. What I end up with is a family of curves like this. But we can put them into three different classes. We can put them into the classes of this bunch, where there are two different roots, and then right up to here, but then this one, it's only got one root. And then up here, it never crosses the axis at all. So there's three different types of quadratic to consider. Quadratics can be the other way up, but that doesn't change the argument. So what is it that distinguishes these three different quadratics? Well, if we concentrate on the roots. This one here has got two different roots. The IB are going to use the word distinct to mean different. This one here has got one root. I'm going to come back to what that means later. And this one, it simply never crosses the axis. So if we're talking about roots, then we should be talking about the place where y is equal to 0. In other words, where this quadratic is equal to 0. Now, how do you solve a quadratic equals 0? Well, that's pretty straightforward, particularly as this one doesn't factorize. We're going to use the formula. Now, the formula has a square root in it. And that means that anything inside a square root is restricted. This ties in with the topic, the domain. We can't take the square root of a negative number in this type of maths. And so this b squared minus 4ac, which I'm going to give the symbol capital D to, so delta is b squared minus 4ac. If we want to have any roots at all, then it can't be negative. So when it is negative, that means there are no roots. And this is the first use of the discriminant. And it is this situation here. There are no roots in this equation, and that is because the discriminant, b squared minus 4ac, is less than 0, which causes an error in our calculation. On the other side of the coin, the simpler side, is when it is bigger than 0. No problem at all. You can take the square root. Let's imagine the discriminant is equal to 4. We can take the square root of 4 and get 2. And then we're going to get two different answers for x, 1 plus, 1 minus. And that's going to lead to this sort of graph. And lastly is the case where the discriminant is equal to 0. And this means that this whole area here is equal to 0. We can forget about it. The square root of of 0 is 0. So we end up with minus b plus or minus nothing. And that means that we only get one root, which is equal to minus b over 2a. Now, you might have seen minus b over 2a before. Where did you see it? Well, it's on the formula book as the equation of the line of symmetry. Minus b over 2a, although it applies to all quadratics, is the line of symmetry. Now, in the case where there is only one root, can you see that the line of symmetry is going to equal the root? Okay, so to summarize then, the discriminant is greater than 0, two distinct roots. It's equal to 0, one repeated root. And it's less than 0, no roots. Let me just give you an example of this repeated root. situation, just a simple question, x squared plus 6x plus 9 equals 0. You'd factorize it. You could have written this as x plus 3 squared. And so you get a root. You get a minus 3 from this bracket and a minus 3 from that one. I actually like to write them both down. You can just write 1. But this is what it means by repeated. A past paper question, for what values of k does this equation have two equal roots? 4x squared plus kx plus 1 equals 0. One of the problems with this topic in past papers is that students sometimes don't realize what topic it is. As soon as you spot this, this is a discriminant question, because it's got this talking about two equal roots, one repeated root, two distinct roots. You see these little phrases, it makes you realize it's a discriminant question. And then when you realize that, it's not very hard. The discriminant is b squared minus 4ac, which we simplify it to be k squared minus 9. And then we just know that for two equal roots, that is code for one repeated root. So we're saying the discriminant is equal to 0. So this is equal to 0. And so k is plus or minus 3. So that's the topic. It's really all about spotting it in the first place.